Now that we have derived all the partitions, it is time for us to actually execute these tests against our program and see if it behaves correctly. And we are going to do this in an automated way by writing JUnit tests. But before doing this, let's remember the partitions we created. We had the first partition, which are numbers divisible by 4 and not divisible by 100. For this one, the program must return true. Next partition, years that are divisible by 4, divisible by 100, and also divisible by 400, the program should also return true. Years that are not divisible by 4, the program should return false. As well as if the year is divisible by 4, divisible by 100, but not divisible by 400. And our development team is quite fast. We already have an implementation for the leap year problem. And as you can see, the code is this isLeapYear method, which receives an integer, the year, and returns a boolean. What we are going to do is to invoke this method with different inputs, different years, based on our partitions. And we will see if the program, or in this case, if this isLeapYear method returns what we expect. Pause the video and take a moment to read the source code. Okay, let's now write an automated test for the first partition. If you remember, for this to be a JUnit test, it should start with @test, and the method should always be public. Let's name it test1. The first thing we should do in our test is to instantiate the class we want to test, or as we call, the class underTest. In this case, this li variable contains a new leap year object. The second step is to execute the method that contains the behavior we want to test. And to do it, we have to pass the year as a parameter. Remember that we are testing the first partition, which is leap years that are divisible by 4 and not divisible by 100. One concrete example for this partition is the year 2016. As this year is a leap year, the correct behavior for this method would be to have the boolean leap equals to true. And this is the third and last part of our automated test. We will assert that the leap variable is true by using the JUnit's assertions.assertTrue method. If we run the test by clicking on the green circle to the left of our test in IntelliJ, we see that the test passes, well, as its color is green. This means that the method behaves correctly for inputs in this partition. But before we move to the next partition, let's first understand one thing. For this partition, years divisible by 4 but not divisible by 100, we provided 2016 as an input. But there are many other possibilities, like 2020 or 2024. Which one should I choose? And the answer for this question is anyone. Clearly, it would be impractical to test all the possible inputs for this partition. However, all of them are equivalent, meaning all of them will exercise the program in the same way. We assume that if one element for this partition works, then all other elements will also work. If one element fails, then all other elements will also fail. As a consequence, there is no point in testing them all. That is why we test a single element per partition. We call it equivalence partitioning. One good tip is to actually name your test methods after the partition. So let's name our previous test from test1 to leap years that are non-centurial years. And we repeat this process for the other partitions. The next partition is leap years that are centurial. We provide the year 2000 for the isLeapYear method, and we assert that its output will be equals to true. Now we get to partitions where years are not leap. The third partition is about years that are centurial and not leap. For example, 1500. In this case, we expect the method to return false. And finally, years that are not centurial and not leap, such as 2017. We expect the method to also return false. Let's run the tests again, but now clicking at the green circle near the class, which makes IntelliJ to run all the tests in this class. We get 4 green tests, which means our program works correctly for the 4 partitions we tested. And as you can see, we wrote automated tests to our leap year program. These automated tests will make sure that this algorithm works forever. After all, in practice, we know how often developers perform maintenance and break working behavior. With automated tests, they will quickly notice if they did something wrong.